फ्रेंड्स, सो वेलकम टू दिस अनदर टॉपिक फ्रॉम द सेम चैप्टर, दिस इज रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट। एंड टुडे आई विल टेलिंग यू अबाउट इमेज फॉर्मेशन बाय अ कन्वेक्स लेंस। सो बिफोर टेलिंग अबाउट दीज इमेज फॉर्मेशंस, लेट अस रिकॉल सम ऑफ द बेसिक थिंग्स दैट वी नो, और इफ सम ऑफ यू डोंट नो सो इट विल बी मोर गुड फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। ओके, सो in our syllabus the types of lenses which are given is 4, but the types of lenses on which the images are given is only of 2 types. So the 4 types of image which you can see in your book is, the first type of image is this. First type of lens, okay, this is known as a biconvex lens. Okay, now why biconvex? Because if we see these both sides, these are made up of 2 convex mirrors. Okay, these 2. And अगर हम लोग को पूछा जाए कि if you face difficulty that how to differentiate between a convex lens and a concave lens, so in convex lens the narrower side is very thin as compared to this middle portion. This middle portion is thick as compared to these 2 narrow ends. This is biconvex. Another part of this biconvex is like this, moon-like lens. Okay, this is a plano convex, as this side is a plane surface and this is made up of a convex mirror. Another type of, a different type of lens, this is biconcave lens, as these both sides are made up of concave mirrors, this as well as this. And the next case is like this, this is plano concave lens. So इन कन्वेक्स लेंस, लेट अस ब्रीफली एक आपको बता दूं कि व्हेन एनी रे ऑफ लाइट कम पैरेलल दे मीट एट अ पॉइंट, आई विल बी टेलिंग यू दिस इन डिटेल जस्ट आफ्टर दिस। एंड इन अ कंकेव लेंस व्हाट हैपेंस दैट व्हेन एवर अ रे ऑफ लाइट कम्स इट डाइवर्जेस। ओके, सो biconvex lens or simply convex lens are converging lens. This is different from the case of mirror. In mirror what happens, the concave mirror is known as the converging mirror, but in case of lens it is opposite. Convex lens are known as converging lens and concave lens diverging, as the rays are diverging. Okay, some of the more points we shall discuss here. Okay, so let us talk about, as this in this video I'll be telling you only about the formation of by a convex lens. In next video I shall talk about image formation by concave lens. So it is important for us to know some of the properties of light passing through a convex lens. So in our syllabus class 10th, only these 2, this and this, only these 2 are in syllabus we'll be dealing with. Okay, so let's see. This, as we all know, the principal axis. Okay, and see, this is the, if we make a full sphere, so this becomes a center of this lens. दिस सेंटर इज नोन एज ऑप्टिकल सेंटर. ओके, ऑप्टिकल सेंटर. एंड सी, सपोज वी हैव टेकन दिस पार्ट एज इन कंसिडरेशन. सो दिस पार्ट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्फीयर, दिस स्फीयर. यस, एंड द सेंटर मीन्स सेंटर ऑफ दिस स्फीयर इज समवेयर लाइक सपोज हेयर. ओके, सो दिस वी कॉल आइदर सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर और वी ऑल्सो कॉल एज 2f. एंड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन the half of distance between this point, that is center of curvature or 2f, and the optical center, which is the center of this lens, is known as f. Okay, so as there are two spherical surface, okay, two part of two spherical surface, so we call it as f1 and 2f1. And like same here, suppose this is a whole sphere of which this part is part of the whole sphere. Okay, so center of this will be 2f1 here and 2f2, and the half the distance between these two is f2. This much it is clear. Okay, so now when a ray of light comes parallel to this principal axis, this is the principal axis. Okay, so when a ray of light is parallel to the principal axis, it passes through the focus like this. Basically it gets refracted. As why this phenomenon takes place, this is the air and this is some another medium, any denser medium. When a ray of light coming from rarer to denser, this will be our normal, so it will bend towards. Basically ये यहीं से bend होना शुरू हो जाता है. Okay, it bends from here only, the point it enters. But to make it more understandable and clear, we make diagrams that start deviating through this point center. Okay, so this is deviating and it passing through the focus. Same way if downside also the same phenomenon will take place. If this ray of light is parallel to this principal axis, it will pass through focus. Okay, another phenomena, basically it is same. I am making it another so it will not be unclear. So if this is f1 and 2f1, this is f2 and this is 2f2. When a ray of light passes through focus, after entering lens, it becomes parallel to this principal axis. Okay, this is the second case. This is the first property, second property, and the last and third property is that, see, this is the optical center. So whenever a ray of light passes through the center of lens, which is optical center, it goes directly without getting deviated. Okay, straight. So these three properties we will use to describe the image formation. Okay, so there are mainly seven cases in image formation as far as I can recall. Let's see how many cases is there exactly. So let us see the first case. This is our convex lens. In real, what happens that this convex lens is very thin, okay, like this, very thin. Okay, but again, to make it more clear for us, we have made this thick just to understand. This is the principal axis, this will be optical center. First focal point, this is called focal point or focus. This is 2f1, this is f2, and this is 2f2. Okay, now let suppose an object is here, okay, which is beyond 2f1, okay, beyond first center of curvature or 2f1. So as discussed in my previous video, we need minimum two light rays to see where the image is formed, because where these two light rays will meet, that place will be the place where the image will be formed. Okay, so let's suppose one ray of light is parallel to principal axis. Okay, so as described here, if a ray of light parallel to the principal axis, it goes through the focus. So ये फोकस से जाएगा यहाँ से F2. ओके, अनदर रे ऑफ लाइट पासिंग थ्रू द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर. ओके, दिस विल गो अनडेविएटेड सिंस इट इज पासिंग थ्रू द ऑप्टिकल सेंटर, सो अनडेविएटेड. नाउ वेयर दिस इमेज इज फॉर्म्ड, हियर दिस टू लाइंस आर मीटिंग, so this image will be formed here. Okay, yes. Now what are the see, I am not making it with the help of a scale or any perfect ray diagram, so the points can be a little bit different, but you can understand. Okay, I have made this. So it is the property that whenever object is placed beyond 2f, it will be formed between this f2 and 2f2. Okay, since the diagram is not clear, that's why it was forming exactly on 2f2, but it will form if you make with scale and proper measurements. It will be formed, the image will be formed between f2 and 2f2. Okay, suppose this is object A and B, so its image will be formed A dash and B dash. See, this point iski ray of light yahan pe aake meet ho rahi hai, to ye wala jo portion hai ye idhar aayega niche. Okay, so one thing you notice, that how much far the object will be with reference point to the lens, jitna is lens se object dur hoga utna image choti hogi, jaise jaise ye paas aate jayega image badi hoti jayegi. Okay, so what will be the properties as it is formed on the other side of the lens? The object is on the left side of the lens and image is on right side, so that it means that it will form on a screen. We can see that image, it will form on a screen. Okay, suppose any wall or something, it will fall, it will, you can see that image. So the properties of this image, that it is a real image, first thing, and this image is inverted. Tedha object is this, okay, image is like this, inverted. Okay, and this is highly diminished, means very small. Highly diminished image. This is the first case. Talking about second case, let's make another. This is another convex lens, not properly made. Okay, this is 2f1. F1, F2 and 2F2. One thing left, this is optical center. So let's now start making object little bit closer to the lens. As it was there beyond 2F2, little bit shift it and place it at 2F1. Now let's see the case. It is passing parallel to principal axis, so it will pass through this point focus. Okay, another ray of light passing through optical center will go undeviated. Okay, this is this goes undeviated. You must mark the arrows to show where the ray of light is going from where to where. So as you can see, these ray of light are meeting here, and this 2f2 will be here. Okay, these ray of light are, the image is formed at 2f2. This is 2f2. Okay, 2f2. So now what you have seen, as the object was little bit more far from the lens, the image was slightly here. As you have made the object little more closer, the image goes little bit more away from the lens. Okay, this is the pattern of the lens. You can very easily understand. So, as it is formed at 2f2. So, when it is at 2f1, the image will be formed at 2f2. AB and A dash B dash. What will the characteristic of this image? It is real. Inverted. If formed other side of the screen, then it is real. At the same time inverted. And this is as the same size. Will be as same size as the object. Okay, so jab bhi object 2f1 pe ho ya center of curvature pe ho, to uske respect mein jo uska image hoga, wo same size ka hoga. This is the second case we have talked about. Okay. Now, let us talk about the third case. Take this third case. Another convex lens. This is the principal axis, optical center, F1, 2F1, F2. And 2f2. Cool. See, object was way far from this lens, somewhat towards closer, and now bring more closer. Make the object between f1 and 2f1. Okay. See now, and here the image was small, it has become same size, and now it will become large. As the object comes towards the lens, the image becomes large. Okay. This ray of light parallel will pass through this focal point. Okay. Another ray of light passing through optical center goes undeviated and meet this line here. So what you can see, image is very large as compared to its object. Okay, here it is. So AB and A dash B dash. So here you can see the image is very large as compared to object, and this, as you are bringing the object closer to lens, image is moving more far from the lens. Here it was here between this, now at this, and now more from this. Okay, so what are the characteristics of this image? Real, okay. Inverted, and formed between, not between, beyond 2f2, which is the second center of curvature. Okay, now we will put object more close to the lens, that is on f1. So let's see what are the results putting it on f1. Okay, I'm drawing it here as the page is not very much good. So let's take example, I guess fourth case. Yes. This will be the plexus, optical center, F1, 2F1, F2 and 2F2. यहाँ पर रखते हैं F1 पे, मोर क्लोज टू द लेंस. सो नाउ सी, इट विल कम पैरेलल टू द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, पासेस फ्रॉम फोकस. अनदर रे कमिंग फ्रॉम ऑप्टिकल सेंटर गोज अनडेविएटेड. सो यू कैन सी नाउ दीज टू लाइंस हैव बिकम पैरेलल टू ईच अदर. Means these two rays will continue going parallel, and they will never meet. Okay. So what happens in this case? Image is real. Okay. If other side, then image is real. Very large it is. Very large, and it is formed. See, it is not forming anywhere. So it is. You will tell it is formed at infinity. 16 फैरेड। नाउ लेट अस सी द फिफ्थ केस। आई गेस देयर आर 6 केसेस, सो लेट अस सी द फिफ्थ केस। दिस फिफ्थ केस यूजुअली मेनी ऑफ अस गेट कंफ्यूज्ड, सो लेट मी मेक एयर because I have written fifth, so it can create a problem. So let's make it here. This is lens, optical center, F1, 2F1, F2 and 2F2. Bring it more closer. Between optical center and F1, first focal point. After being parallel, light ray passing through focus. Okay, another light ray will pass through optical center, goes undeviated. Now what you have seen that if we produce these two rays backwards, okay, these two rays are meeting here, that means that the image is formed here. And since the light rays are going from this point and they are hitting me, they are meeting here, so image of this point will be only formed at the upper side. So what this means that as the object is straight, image is also straight. And if it is formed on the same side of the lens where the object is, that means that image is virtual. It will not be formed on screen. So in only this case, when the object is between F1 and O, the image is virtual. Rest all cases the images are real. So characteristic of this image, it is virtual and it is erect since it is not inverted. So it is erect and this image is highly enlarged as compared to this object. So we will write highly enlarged. Okay, now one case I forgot to tell you. This is the fifth case. So yeah. Let me tell you on this page. This is the sixth and the last case. Basically it should be first, but as I forget, so it is last, but no ways. This is a convex lens. Now F1, 2F1, this is F2 and this is 2F2. Now suppose let us take a case when the rays of light of an object are coming from infinity. Let's suppose sun. Okay. So in that case what happens? Let us see. Suppose a ray of light coming from this and ray of light. Since these two rays are parallel, they are coming from infinity. Okay, they may not be meeting at any place, so we can consider that this is coming from infinity. To the rule, when a ray of light comes parallel to principal axis, it goes towards the focus or passes through the focal point of focus. This ray will also pass through focus, this ray will also pass through. So where is the image formed? The image will be formed at here, exact the focus. As two lines are meeting at here only, so the image will form like a small dot line. So as you can see, if way beyond, so image is very less, way less, point like object may be as big as infinity, but its image is formed here at a dot. So these are the six cases of image formation. I hope you got and understood how ray of light if passed through where, so where it gets deviated. So I hope you liked my video, and in the next video I shall be talking about image formation by a concave lens. That is also very easy, same type of, always virtual image is formed in that case. So I'll be coming with next video very soon. Till then, thank you. If you have any doubt, please post it in the comment box. Thank you.